school youth. It'll be run by a pair of experts who also work with survivors in New York and Pennsylvania, only victims of youth as mine are others. And the Diocese of Arlington, Virginia, releases a list of credibly accused priests dating back to his establishment in 1974. In a letter from Arlington Bishop Michael Burbridge says he remained open to meet with survivors. For more news with a Catholic perspective, visit EWTNnews.com. Catholic Answers Live starts now.
Being with you 4 days out of the five this week, and I have on my own show. If you haven't heard about it, I'll let you know. It's Take Two with Jerry and Debbie. And 5 days this week, Monday through Friday at noon Eastern on many of these same EWTN affiliates, and replay of that show at midnight Eastern time. So hopefully you can catch me and Debbie. We just talked about the stuff that life has been on for years, talk about what's going on in your life and ours, and have a conversation where you drive the program. So check it out. Regular basis, but it's always good to be back in the host chair here at Catholic Answers Live, and very blessed event for me today. I hosted the show for just about the first 10 years of its existence, and one of the regular guests was our good friend Marcellino D'Ambrosio. He comes with us in the first hour today. Marcellino is a well-known author and speaker. He has a PhD in theology under the guidance of theologian Cardinal Avery Dulles. He teaches at Catholic Distance University, and you'll find him online at DrItaly.com. Marcellino, what a great experience for me. I hope it is for you, too.
Of course it is, Jerry. It's a blessing.
You're not going to say anything else in front of 6 billion people around the world, I know. So.
That's correct.
Great to be back with you. And we're going to talk about the divinity of Jesus and why that is important for us to understand as Christians. So I want to open up a phone line first before we get into this with Marcellino. You can call us. If you have questions about just how to better understand the divine nature of Jesus, the personhood of Jesus. He has the two natures, of course, human and divine, but he was a divine person. So how do we make sense of all of that? If you kind of better be able to explain it to those who are here. That he was not divine and not God. There are a lot of people who say that Jesus is a great man, prophet, and our Father. There are some religions that teach that. Maybe you want to bolster your scriptural support for Christ's divinity. Where in the Bible can I turn to when people question me about that? Or why is it important that Jesus was both human and divine? Let's talk about these things. Here's the phone number, 888-318-7884 is our phone number to call. Before we get into the material here, Marcellino, I know you're one of the most popular Catholic speakers out there. I know you're a busy guy, but I would say you've got a few mission dates still available.
We do. Yeah, I'm tracing around the country.
This Lent, for sure. No doubt about it.
But there are some spaces open. And what I love to do in Lent is help people approach Lent in a new way. Talk about Lent in terms of not so much just giving stuff up, but really spiritual training, you know?
A lot of people do training.